Success isn't a once-in-a-lifetime transformation. It's the product of your daily habits. It's making tiny changes to achieve remarkable results because habits are the compound interest of self-improvement. This is the power of atomic habits. By the end of this video, you'll understand how to use the four laws of behavior change along with Notion to master your habits. The habit tracker dashboard as well as the atomic habits checklist that I'll be using in this video can be found down in the description. Now let's get started. The first thing that you'll see when you duplicate this template is a summary of the Atomic Habits book. In this page, there's a summary of each of the chapters going over all the most important information from this book. Next is a daily quotes database that will show a new quote every day from the Atomic Habits book. Then underneath this, you have the actual Atomic Habits checklist with a button for each of the chapters that will load a condensed summary as well as an exercise for you to complete. Now, before we start with this, let me first show you where to find this Atomic Habits checklist on the Habit Tracker Hub dashboard. You'll be able to find the daily Atomic Habit quotes underneath the accountability partner and the actual checklist you can find inside of the bookshelf when you open up Atomic Habits. How this Atomic Habits checklist works is fairly simple. You just click on this button, click on continue, and it will load a checkbox for each of these buttons, which contains an exercise inside that you have to fill out in order to mark this checkbox as complete. Now let's go through each of these buttons. This first button is about the three levels of behavior change. You can either try to change your outcomes, which is focused on goals, the process, which is focused on systems, or your identity, which is focused on beliefs. If you truly want to change your life, it needs to happen from the inside out. You need to start with your identity and work your way out to the outcomes. An outcome-based approach focuses on what you want to achieve, and an identity-based approach focuses on who you wish to become. Our identity is being shaped by our habits, and our habits is shaping our identity. The key lesson here is that habits aren't about having something, it's about becoming someone. And at the bottom of this chapter, I have an exercise that you can fill out in order to define the type of person you need to become in order to be successful with your habits. So for example, the goal is not to read a book, it's to become a reader. The goal is not to run a marathon, it's to become a runner. The goal is not to create YouTube videos, it's to become a YouTuber. So all you need to do here is just add in your habits, and then the goal for each habit, and then the type of person you need to become in order to be successful with that habit. And then whenever you have a decision to make, you can just use this question. So for example, if you want to lose weight, you would just ask yourself, what would a healthy person do? Or if you want to be more productive, you would just ask yourself, what would a productive person do? And on a long enough time frame, if you constantly act like a healthy person, then you'll eventually become a healthy person. And at the end of each exercise, there's a link to a chapter of the book where that exercise is from. Now, once this exercise is complete, you can just close this toggle and then you can mark this checkbox as done. Now, the next button inside of the fundamentals chapter is the four laws of behavior change. Inside of this button, you'll learn the four-step process of building habits. First, you have the cue, which is the habit trigger. Then you have the craving, which is the desire for the habit. Then you have the response, which is the actual habit that you perform. And then you have the reward, which is the end goal of every habit. Now, once you understand this four-step process, you can either use it to create good habits or you can use it to break bad habits. The first law of behavior change is for the cue, which is to make the habit obvious. And if it's for bad habits that you want to remove, then you're just going to flip it on its head and you're going to make the habit invisible. The second law of behavior change is for the craving, which is to make the good habit attractive and the bad habit unattractive. The third law is to make it easy, and for the bad habit to make it difficult. And the fourth law is to make it satisfying, and for the bad habit to make it unsatisfying. Now, it's important to note that this isn't a linear four-step process. It's actually a habit loop where the cue triggers a craving, the craving motivates a response, the response provides a reward, which satisfies the craving, and then ultimately it becomes associated with the cue, which forms a habit loop. Now, the exercise for the section is going to be to add in all of your good habits and then just define how you can make each one obvious, attractive, easy, and satisfying. And then you're going to do the exact same thing for the bad habits, except you're going to define how you can make it invisible, unattractive, difficult, and unsatisfying. And again, you can just click on this link, which will take you to the chapter summary. And once you're done with the exercise, you just go back to your checklist and then mark this one as complete. Now, I'm not going to go through every single button as it's quite a lot to cover, but all of these are strategies, methods, and principles you can use to help you with each of the four laws of behavior change. So for example, in order to make a habit more obvious, you can use the habit scorecard, implementation intention, habit stacking, and environment design. In order to make it more attractive, you can use temptation bundling and reframing difficult habits. In order to make it easy, you can prime your environment, use the 2-minute rule and commitment devices. And then in order to make it more satisfying, you can use habit incentives, habit tracking, and also the habit contract. And then at the end, there's also two buttons from the Advanced Tactics chapter, which is for exploring habits and also reviewing your habits. Now let me show you how this Habit Tracker Hub dashboard uses all four laws of behavior change to help you with your habits. Now I'll just quickly again mention that the link and tutorial to this Habit Tracker Hub dashboard can be found down in the description. Now the first law is to make it obvious. Every day when you open up Notion, the very first thing that you'll see is going to be your day's database, showing your total daily habit progress for both your good and bad habits. And then you'll also see your accountability partner showing your total daily progress and all the habits that you still need to complete for the day. Now, sometimes we have a distorted view of our own behavior. We think we act better than we do, but when the evidence is right in front of you, just like how it is here, you're less likely to lie to yourself, which is why tracking your habits needs to be obvious. The second law of behavior change is to make it attractive. Habit tracking needs to provide visual proof of your hard work because the most effective form of motivation is progress. Now for this Habit Tracker, it shows your daily habit progress, but it also shows your weekly progress, your monthly progress, your quarterly progress, and also your yearly progress. And on our accountability partner, you'll see our daily habit progress for Tuesday's 40%, and that we've only completed one out of our three good habits. So if you open up Tuesday and complete another one, you'll see that the habit will disappear. It will now show two out of our three habits has been completed, and the color of the percentage will also change as it increases. The third law of behavior change is to make it easy. Now, this habit tracker makes it super easy to track your habits. If I just remove these days, we can just click on this button to add a new week to our days database. We can open up Tuesday, and then there will be a synced block that loads where we can click this button to add today's date, which will make it show up on the accountability partner. We can click on this add week button to link this day to a week, which will make it show up here. And we can also use these buttons to add our good and bad habits to this day database. Or we can use these day buttons if we have specific habits for specific days, and then all of our habits will show up here with a checkbox, which you can just click to mark your habits as complete. Alternatively, you can also use these buttons at the bottom to mark your habits as complete. And these buttons is also inside of the mobile habits page, which you can add as a widget on your phone so that you can mark your habits as complete while you're on the go. Now, it's important to remember that tracking your habits is a habit in of itself. And as with any habit, the greater the friction, the less likely the habit. So if there's anything you can do to make tracking your habits easier, then do it. Because it's in our human nature to follow the law of least effort, which states that given two options, we will naturally gravitate toward the path of least resistance. So try to make your habit tracking easy. Now, the fourth law of behavior change is to make it satisfying. Now, the way this habit tracker does this, besides everything that we've already covered, is going to be through the accountability partner. Now, at the bottom of this accountability partner, you'll see the good and bad habits that you still need to complete for the day. And once you've completed all of your bad habits for the day, you'll get a message that says, "Nice job. Looks like you're stronger than your bad habits." And if you complete all of your good habits for the day, you'll have a message that says, "Good job, you're slowly becoming the person you know you could be." And if we complete all of our habits for the day, all of this will disappear and you'll get a message that says, "Well done, you're clearly disciplined and focused on improving your life. Keep it up, Chris." And even though this is not related to habits, it's the exact same thing for your daily tasks, where you'll get a message that says, "Nice job, you completed all your daily tasks. Now go do something fun." And then I think it's also worth showing that if we don't have any task for today, or if we don't have any habits, then the accountability partner will tell you that you don't have any tasks, good habits, or bad habits for today yet. And if we remove this date, then it will say, "Looks like you have not added your daily habits yet." Now, of course, in this video, I'm using my Habit Tracker Hub dashboard as an example of how Notion could be used in terms of tracking your habits, but you can apply the same principles to your own Notion Habit Tracker. And this Atomic Habits checklist is not a supplement for reading the book. You still need to read the book. This is just so that you don't have to summarize it yourself. And the actionable practical steps discussed in the book is conveniently organized and structured in a way that makes it easy for you to implement. When it comes to self-development books like Atomic Habits, you're supposed to be studying the books, not read the books. You need to extract key information and summarize the book. You need to highlight and take notes, and you need to be able to internalize and digest the book so that you can act on everything that you've learned. Everything I've just mentioned, I've already done for you with Atomic Habits. So if you want to save time and just grab this checklist for yourself, then be sure to check out the first link in the description. If you found this video useful, then be sure to give it a like. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.